We'll start now. Yeah. So once we understood this distribution ET versus T, yeah, something like this, we have to now talk about you know, the mean and variance of this. You know, for any distribution you have area under the curve, okay, and also the mean. Mean is given by the first moment, correct? No, moment of first, yeah, and also you have the variance, okay, second moment. So those things also will come here. The reason is using this T bar and also, you know, variance, we can find out the non-ideal parameters. What are the non-ideal parameters? For example, axial mixing. That is one parameter. How much axial mixing is there? Quantification. How do you quantify axial mixing? You have to quantify axial mixing only in terms of dispersion number. Okay, that dispersion number we can calculate using this, you know, variance and first moment, second moment, and all that. And most of the time, we will not go for F curve, but we will go for the E curve. This kind of distribution, right? So, the general definition of this distribution is that, okay, MK, kth moment, is 0 to infinity t to the power of k e t dt divided by 0 to infinity e t dt. Okay? That is the general one. Good? Okay. So, if I want to take 0th moment, what do I do? K equal to 0, M 0 will be what? 1. So, what is the meaning of that? Devayan, what does 0th moment give? Okay, what is initial? What is first moment? First moment is mean. Okay. Second moment is variance. But 0th moment is area under the curve. So M 0, when we put here 1, what is the total area under the curve? We have normalized this. That is why you have integral C divided by integral 0 to infinity c dt and all that is there. Okay? So, that area under the curve, this area M 0 is equal to 1 area. Okay? That is 1. So, M 1 is 0 to infinity t e t 0 to infinity e t dt, right? That is 0th, I mean t bar. And okay, M 1 is nothing but, for us, it is t bar, right? It is nothing but t bar for us, yeah, because this average will be somewhere here depending on the shape of the curve. So, this is t bar, right? And this also can be written as, yeah, what is 0 to infinity e t dt? 1. So, that is why this is also equivalent to 0 to infinity t e t dt, right? Okay, good. So, now the, yeah, okay, variance, I think, you know, there is difference between variance and what the other one, no? Standard deviation. Okay, yeah. What is this one? Sigma square is m 2 minus m 1 square.
Not
again.
M2 is T square.
That is standard deviation.
Standard deviation.
Okay? Yeah. So, this will be for us, M2 is, of course, anyway, you have to the same thing. So, this is yeah, M2, please see, M2 means T k equal to 2. So, T square and E T dt divided by this one. That is 1. That is why I am not writing that, but I will simply write here 0 to infinity t square e t dt minus t bar square, minus t bar square, correct, no? yeah, t bar square, or otherwise of course, I have to put this one and then put whole square. So, these are the, beyond this normally we do not go, third moment generally we do not go, right. And there are some cases where people have gone to third moment also. And most of the time for single parameter models, using this and using this, we can estimate, for example, d by ul values. D by ul is quantifying mixing, and also tanks in series, right. I have 10 tanks in series. I will conduct RTD experiment, and then I will find out whether these 10 tanks are behaving really as 10 tanks or not, because ideal tanks 10 must behave as 10 tanks. Okay. So, and if it is non-ideal, that may be equivalent to 8 tanks equivalent. That you can get again from RTD, you have to have that curve, and then you find out variance of that curve. And you know, very beautiful expression, there is one very simple expression in chemical engineering, sigma theta is square equal to 1 by n. Heard of it, Swami? Never. Yeah, in RTD it comes. Those who have got, I think, some good RTD exposure in their BTech and MTech, they know this. And also, there is another equation also, sigma theta square equal to 2 d by ul, where sigma theta square equal to, you know, that is dimensionless variance, okay, dimensionless variance. So, those things we have to find out, okay, good. So, this is one, and yeah. And there is another one, Lyon-Speyer simplifies this 2 in terms of even concentrations. So, that means, if I have simply C versus T, will the shape changes? Shape is exactly same, but only thing is scaling will change. Okay? So, that is why distribution will not change. That means, again my sigma square, and also that m 1, you know, t bar, that will not change. How do I find out t bar from here? So, yeah, for this one, t bar will be integral 0 to infinity t c t d t divided by, no, this is not 1. So, I cannot ignore that. That is not 1. So, this also can be written as sigma of, yeah, T c delta t divided by sigma of c delta t. If you take equal intervals of delta t, then this also will get cancelled. So, this will be simply sigma T c by sigma c equal to T bar. This is what is the problem he has also solved as an example in his book, Lyon-Speyer book, right. So, these things are a must for us, because for every distribution, you are going to find out what will be the, t bar and sigma square. These two are a must for us. Okay? Good. So, this is the one. And like this, you have, yeah, I think even using same thing for this distribution, sigma square also you can calculate as, I will write here to differentiate. This t is okay, t bar, or this t bar is okay. Yeah, this is, t square equal to, we have I am giving the final expression. Divided by sigma of what? C delta t minus t bar square. If delta t is again, if you are taking same, maybe 1 minute, 1 minute, and you should take as small as possible. If you take bigger one, then you will get more error. Okay? Yeah, depending on the data. So, this also can be written as sigma of t I c I c a also by sigma c I minus. So, these are the equations what we have, and most of the time in the examination also we will be asking this, right. Yeah. So, from the data, we will give concentration versus time data, and these distributions we are talking about only for this kind of increasing and decreasing. F curve also has some distributions which are valid both, and that we are not doing that. Okay, good, that is fine. So now, I think this is enough for us as far as this is concerned, and there are other things now which also we need before going further to develop the equations. That is, okay, Dirac delta function, we have to do one thing, and the other thing is, let me first do dimensional, the relationship between E t and F t. It is obvious relationship E t and F t. Okay. So, we know that F t equal to 0 to t, there is no infinity here, E t d t. So, I told you E t will, pulse input will give you E t and step input will give you F t. But once you conduct, let us say E t, that means pulse input, can you convert that into F t? Easy, that is straightforward. The reverse also, that means you conduct F t, that is step input experiment, and then try to find out E t. How do you do that? Differentiate this. This is d F t by d t equal to E t. What is the meaning of this? Meaning is, I have F t curve versus t, like this. What do I do? You have to find slopes at various points. Okay. So, when you take the slopes at various points, right? So, this shape, what kind of shape E t I will get here? E t versus t. Initially, what is the slope?
Zero.
Almost zero. And at some time it goes to increasing, increasing, and afterwards again decreasing. So, what shape you get? Exactly. Like this. Initially it is zero slope, and then slowly it is increasing, reaches maximum, and then afterwards comes down. Zero. This slope is zero, no? So you will get like this one again. So you should get see the same thing. Okay. So this is, that means one is possible to see the other one, that is all. Okay, good. So, the other one which I have to tell you now is, because all these things are required for us. Okay, I think later I can tell, because all chemical engineers are very famous for dimensionless distributions, dimensionless parameters. So, that also I have to write, because E t we are talking, what are the units of E t?
Time.
So, I will try to convert that into E theta, where there are no dimensions. That will come a little bit later, but I think before that, let us complete with T everything. And there is one more thing which we have to discuss here, it is Dirac delta function. Dirac delta function, which is normally shown as like this, infinity, this is time, this is whatever that function. Okay. Please take this. Dirac delta function is defined, this is required. I think this is why Lebesgue's book, many people like it, because he knows that none of us are capable of remembering all this. So, that is why he gives in his book also these definitions again, so that we do not lose. We are not lost. Dirac delta function is defined to deal with discontinuous calculus. Dirac delta function is defined to deal with discontinuous functions in calculus. Discontinuous functions in calculus. Thus, please write, thus delta t minus, this is our representing, t minus t naught is a distribution curve which is 0 everywhere which is 0 everywhere except t equal to t naught, except t equal to t naught, where it is infinity. Okay, where it is infinite, right? Okay, next line, I think you know these things are required because in an ideal P of R, what is the output you are getting? Ideal P of R. ET is defined only for ideal P of R in terms of Dirac delta function. That is why. And using that also, we can calculate, you know, from RTD, you can calculate volume and also conversion, given volume conversion, given conversion volume from RTD side. Okay? So, that is why this some idea about this Dirac delta functions are required. Good. So, next line you just write. The area under the curve is unity and the width of the pulse is 0. In symbols, you can write this delta t minus t naught equal to infinity at t equal to t naught and delta t minus t naught equal to 0 elsewhere. Okay, such that minus infinity to plus infinity delta t minus t naught dt equal to 1. You are able to see my handwriting? I am becoming worse and worse. Such that is the area under the curve. Minus infinity to plus infinity, but that function is valid only at t equal to t naught. But only thing is, it should be somewhere between minus infinity to plus infinity, that t naught must be there. That's all, that is the requirement. Okay? So, that is one. You know, if you really see mathematics and history of mathematics, these functions are defined to solve some physical problems. Otherwise, it is not just for fun they have defined. So, they started solving, you know, particularly how a universe started and the mathematics they started deriving. Under some conditions, they have to define some functions. All these functions are like that. So, that is why most of the people talking about astronomy and also, you know, this universe, how it started and all that, they must be an excellent mathematicians. Otherwise, they cannot. And those are the people who defined many, many new functions. And of course, later in engineering, these functions also are used to represent, you know, Dirac delta function, impulse function, all that. So, that is why if you read the history, that is why, you know, we do not have good syllabus, I say. So, the good syllabus should also contain stories in chemical engineering. Yeah, really? Stories in mathematics, stories in physics. Stories in physics and mathematics are thousands. Okay? So, how this idea started and all that, how chemical engineering started, I have a story. I will tell sometime later, you know, in the department or outside, I think. I have to give that story also, otherwise people are forgetting about that stories. How chemical, what is the starting point? The real starting point for chemical engineering is the industries. Sulfuric acid industry, calcium carbonate industry. You know, those are the washing soda. Washing soda is calcium carbonate. No, sodium carbonate. Yeah. Those industries, which were a must at that time. I am talking about 1600, 1700, 1800. And you know, I was worrying, you know, recently I not worrying, actually I felt also very bad about the way we are now teaching, the way we are behaving as faculty also, that we never tell you anything about industry. Correct, no? Just happily coming and then writing some very nice beautiful equations, right? And then you nod your head as if you understood, and I will take it that as if you understood, and then exam is conducted, over. Where is chemical industry? This is what is the problem with people who are doing simulations. Without knowing rotameter, they simulate rotameter. Okay, I mean, just simplest example I am telling. So, that is why you simulate. Simulate is required once you have thorough physical concepts. Then simulation, then understanding automatically comes. Not the other way. First simulate and then, you know, without knowing why you are simulating and then trying to find out something out of that. And, you know, when I say that, all of you will be thinking that this man does not know simulation, that is why he is telling. Okay? I mean, this is a logical conclusion. Okay? All of you will be telling, or otherwise they may be thinking this guy is against with that simulator. So, that is why I think he is So, you know, all these idiotic things, you know, mind always goes in wrong direction only. If I tell you don't go in this direction, your curiosity will increase. Why did he tell, you know, this go? You asked me not to go in that direction. So, you finally go only in that direction. Okay? And if I ask you, okay, go this direction, you don't care. Don't go means, you know, it is the thing. So, that is why all these functions have really beautiful stories. And those stories, I think, unfortunately, we are missing it. I don't know, in the schools also, they are not able to tell. And this planet lacks wonderful teachers now. That is what? Wonderful teachers who knows the stories more. History is very important, I say. You may not care, because you also don't know history. You know only your father or maximum his father. Beyond that, who is his father, where they stayed, I think 90% of the students, I mean, this generation, we don't know that. Correct, no? Because now the single families and mother-in-law will not accept father-in-law, father-in-law will not accept daughter-in-law, daughter-in-law are in-laws only. Okay. one in-law, I mean, actually, you know, I like the best word in English is this brother-in-law, sister-in-law, daughter-in-law. Okay, when I have daughter-in-law, you know what is the real meaning of that? In-law, she is my daughter. When you have brother-in-law, in-law, he is your brother. In-law. Okay, that means as per law is concerned, he or she, you know, correspondingly daughter or sister or brother. It is a wonderful expression, no? In other languages, we don't have that kind of beauty. Only that English language, only this word only, I really like it. Okay. But in Telugu, we will call, if you have brother, Anna, if he is elder brother. Okay, I think Tamil also Anna, Tambi. That's all. But I think, you know, whoever it is, brother is universal. And if you go to some other family, you are still brother, but in-law. Okay, if your daughter goes to some other family, she is still daughter there, but in-law. So, it is wonderful. So, like that, there are many, many things if you are... You may be thinking that this fellow doesn't have any other work. Really, I don't have any other work. I don't have really any other work, thinking like this only. And I don't know how to pay tax and I don't know how to go. In fact, I cannot even manage TT if I don't have a seat in the train. I don't know how to ask him, you know, can you take money and then give. And I don't know, I am afraid to ask. So, that is why travel, I think, either standing or sitting, whatever is available. That's all. I don't know how to manage. And now young people will go with that pant and then something hanging here, something hanging here. Oh, correct, no? So, all wide and then they just simply go that 100 rupees, take it, give me seat. We are not able to do that. I think, you know, I am a very useless fellow. That's why, to tell you the secret, always my wife scolds me. Because I don't know what to do. And I don't know even to go and manage with this gas fellow. Now they started giving only limited gas and all that. So, you know, like that. So, that is why I started thinking I am enjoying it. I don't know. Okay. Okay, good. So, that is why these functions also have, it is not simply mathematical functions without any physics. To solve some problems only, all these functions have come into picture. Okay, many, many functions. Good. So, then we will have some more properties. Okay, please write this. The useful property of this function is, the useful property of this function is a to b delta t minus t naught f of t dt, yeah, equal to, who said that? Oh, Dinesh, how do you know? Huh? Already did it where? Which subject? Oh, here you did it already, okay. F t naught. Okay. But only thing is, what is the requirement, Dinesh? Requirement is? Yeah, exactly. E naught must lie between those two integrals. Limits. That is very important. Otherwise, if it is somewhere else, we cannot do anything. So, otherwise it is? Zero. If t naught lies outside a to b, not a minus b. Okay, so that is one. So now I will just give you one, I think all of you may be easily getting this. So to calculate, okay, 2 to 4 delta t minus 3 t square dt, what is the value? Olga is very seriously thinking. Olga, I am waiting for you. 9, why 9? What is the function corresponding to this? This f t, it is t square. Right? So, it is inside the interval. T minus 3 between 2 and 4. Right? So, this is t naught, this is 3, this is f t, this is t square. Then what it must be? Good. So, one more example, 0 to 2 delta t minus 3 t square dt. 0, because I think that is okay. Yeah. Now, one more is this, minus infinity plus infinity delta t e power minus k t dt. Why 1? That is t minus 0. Okay. So, this will be e power minus 0. So, that is 1. So, this is e power minus 0 equal to 1. Okay. So, like that you have all the functions, that is good. I think this is 1 and all other things are fine. So, these things are also required for us after some time, when you are actually solving the problems. And now, let us see the dimensionless E t, F t, E theta, F theta, etcetera. So, next one is dimensionless E t, F t or E theta and F theta. So, we have to make E t and F t dimensionless. So, we call them E theta and F theta. So, first we define, sorry?
F t is already dimensionless.
So, everything we will write dimensionless, we will write here E theta, F theta. So, that means we would like to express that in terms of time also dimensionless. Okay? So, that is why. Okay, the first definition is theta equal to t by logically t bar. Okay? Yeah. So, that is the one. So, now can you make E t into E theta? There are many ways of making. Anyway, I think instead of asking you, I will tell you. So, I have here E t versus t. Right? So, the shape may be, general shape is like this. Good. So, what is the area? Abdul? 1. So, now first thing is I have to change the t into theta. So, that is why I divide this scale by t bar. Okay? So, now I will leave E t as it is. Now, what will be the area under the curve? The same thing, if I divide by t bar, what will be area under the curve? 1 by t bar. But my requirement is area equal to 1. So, what should I do? Multiply by t bar. So, that is why you have here t bar E t, which is nothing but E theta. So, then again you get almost same shape, area equal to area equal to 1. Okay? So, that is E theta. E theta now does not have units. Yeah. You can also do this, mathematically, that is 0 to infinity E t d t. How do you convert that into E theta? Again, t bar funda, t equal to d t, because t definition I know, d t equal to t bar
theta d t bar.
So, this is 0 to infinity, yeah, this is E t, t bar theta, right, d t if I sub, d theta, t bar d theta. So, this is now E theta. So, this is equal to 0 to infinity E theta d theta. Okay, Reshmi, no problems. Okay, so now FT. Now FT, someone was telling that when I write FT, FT is dimensionless. Okay, but we want to convert that into F theta, right? Yeah. So FT equal to 0 to T. Please remember T, ET, DT. Can you convert this one into F theta? Again, same funda says. Substitute for T, DT. Otherwise, we don't know, I think, what limit you are putting. If she has not asked that question, we should have accepted. I also should have not mentioned, things would have gone. So, our ignorance should have been there all the time. Okay? It is theta, 0 to theta. So, this will be 0 to theta e theta d theta, which is nothing but f theta. Right now? So, Ft equal to Ft equal to F theta. That is all. Ft equal to F theta. Ft, yeah. You will get that, I think, you know, because you see here we have E theta theta, right? This is equal to theta, right? T by T bar. So, what is F theta? This must be, this area equal to F theta equal to integral 0 to theta e theta d theta. Correct, no? So, this area again is exactly same as this area, area wise, because but this is theta value and this is t value, that is all. So, that is why F t equal to F theta, right? Good. So, why we are doing that is, when you are actually writing models for example, axial dispersion model or CSTR with dead space, CSTR with bypass or CSTR with bypass and dead space both. When we are actually doing all that, so many times we will derive the equation in terms of E theta or F theta, which is dimensionless. By the way, why do you use dimensionless equations in chemical engineering? I think not only chemical engineering, in engineering, civil engineering also they use. But I think chemical engineers use lot of dimensionless equations because we have mass transfer, heat transfer and also fluid and also reaction engineering. For example, Damkohler number is a dimensionless number. Huh? What analogy? Not every time, but I think except in friction factor only has that relationship. So, F by 2 equal to? Yeah, I mean first let me come back to you. Yeah, F by 2 equal to? You heard of JD, JH? Nowadays many young teachers are not telling JD and JH. That is low funda. Okay, yeah, whole bond factors and all that, yeah. So, JD equal to JH equal to, JH takes care of heat, JD takes care of diffusion mass and F by 2 takes care of, yeah, that is a beautiful analogy between mass, momentum and heat. That is one, but not that is mainly. Mainly, it is only to take care of the dimensions, because I can convert always my system into 0 to 1, okay, or in terms of 1, 2, 5, 10, like that, units. So, that is why we have so many unit, you know, dimensionless modeling equations, where I do not have to talk now what is exact length. You see, when I am talking about length of the plug flow, I do not have to tell whether it is 10 feet or 20 feet or 3 meters or 10 meters. I can only simply that dimensionless length is 0.5. So, whatever length you put there, if it is 5 meters, it will be 2.5 meters. If it is 5 kilometers, if it is 2.5 kilometers. So, that is one of the main advantages when dealing with dimensionless parameters. But you have to choose correctly what are the parameters you have to use so that you will get logical dimensionless quantities. That is one of the main important things in chemical engineering. Why we do that? So maybe some of you in your projects also do that. Make it dimensionless, we say in the beginning, and then solve that in terms of differential equations or whatever. Good? Okay, good. So this is the one, and So now when I have this kind of distribution E theta versus theta, this kind of distribution E theta versus theta, this also will have variance, and also it will have, the theta bar. Okay. So what is now equation for theta bar here for this case? That is like T bar. Here I have theta bar. That may be one. Okay. But what is the equation for that? You know already. So that's why I am telling. It is exactly like the definition 0 to infinity theta E theta d theta divided by 0 to infinity E theta d theta, which is equal to 0.5 theta. So this is one, no? This is one. So this becomes 0 to okay. So now sigma theta square equal to same thing, 0 to infinity theta square E theta d theta, 0 to infinity E theta d theta, which is again, minus 1. Okay, minus 1, minus 1, or you know, actually this theta equal to 1, right? Okay, this is 1 square is 1 only. So this is also equal to, you can take only this because this is equal to 1. So 0 to infinity theta square E theta d theta minus 1, which is also equal to sigma of theta square E theta delta theta. This theta bar equal to 1. Otherwise theta bar square you can write. Okay, no problem. This is also theta bar square. Okay, theta bar square. Right, you know, see when what you have to do is that when you conduct the experiment and you will have first C versus T data. So that can be converted into E T. Then it also can be converted into E theta. If someone gives you directly E theta versus theta data and ask you what is sigma theta square, let us say sigma theta square, after doing all this, I will get 0.1 example. Okay. So from my Tangsin series model, this sigma theta square equal to 1 by n, where n equal to number of tanks. Now from the data, I conducted the experiments on that setup, and then I found out sigma theta square equal to 0.1. So on how many number of tanks we have? 10. That is, what is the advantage? 0.1, n equal to 10. That is the answer. That means, you know that the Tangsin series model can also be used for plug flow. Theoretically, if you have infinity, you will get a plug flow, right? But still, you may not have that kind of infinite number of tanks. So, you conduct the experiments on supposed to be plug flow reactor, it is not plug flow. Now, you can now convert that into equivalent number of how many tanks. Why? Because if I know number of tanks 10, if I have first order reaction, right, what is the equation for conversion?
Plus 1 by 1 plus k tau.
Xi equal to 1 minus 1 by 1 plus k
tau.
Yeah, tau to the power of, this is 10 tanks, I say. 10. So then I can calculate very easily the actual conversion that is coming from the system. I have the packed bed, right, but you know, I do not want to go to dispersion model and then do it, because I think Tangsin series model also can represent the flow inside through some number. I do not know what is the number. So I will conduct RTD experiment. I will get E theta versus theta curve, C versus T and all that, convert this, right. And in fact, you do not have to go even for that. So this is also nothing but sigma T square by T bar square. That is the definition of sigma theta square, sigma theta square. So even T curve, concentration versus time curve, we can calculate sigma T square, T bar square. That is nothing but sigma theta square, which is, let us say, 0.1, what you got from the experiment. So now use that to calculate what will be the number of tanks in series, and from there I know if it is first order, because first order is easy to remember, that is why I am telling. So, first order equation is Ca by Ca naught equal to 1 by 1 plus k tau to the power of n, the tau is for each tank, tau I to the power of n, n I know 10. Now, I can calculate Ca by Ca naught, which is nothing but 1 minus Xa. So, conversion I can calculate. That is the reason why we are interested in this sigma theta square, sigma t and all that. Similarly, d by u l. Okay, axial mixing I am trying to find out axial mix in terms of d by u l. Now, d by u l may be 0.1. If I have that much d by u l, how do I calculate conversion? That is not that easy to the way 1 by 1 plus k tau to the power of n. There is a more complicated equation which I tell you later. So, that is the equation which you have to use for calculating conversion. That is the connection between RTD and the conversion equations. Right. So, first find out whether the reactor is ideal. If it is not ideal, you do not know what is the axial mixing. Conduct RTD experiment, find out what is the dispersion. And to find out what the d by u l, you need this equation. Right. So, once you know this equation, then you can go back, estimate what is the d by u l. Go to that equation, which equation? Conversion equation. That conversion equation has d by u l, because you are assuming it is axial mixing model. Substitute there and then calculate. That will come a little bit later, but now itself I am giving you the introduction. Okay, good. So, these are the things now. So, what is left now is the ideal, let us now derive the RTD functions for the ideal reactors. Ideal reactors we have mixing flow and plug flow. So, these two. Okay. RTD functions for ideal reactors. Ideal reactors, first let us take PF, plug flow reactor. Okay. Plug flow reactor, this is now ideal plug flow reactor. Good. So, we have here volumetric flow rate V coming out. So, yeah, this is P of R. Okay, let me write here P of R. First, let me conduct the pulse input experiment. Pulse input. So, pulse input is a Dirac delta function which is simply entering here. This is at time t equal to 0. Okay. How do I inject that? Because I have to very carefully take some, without any disturbance, some syringe or something, and then just inject, which will go and then sit down throughout the cross section. That means your disk, that is what is the ideal one, and in reality it is not so easy. Okay. So, that is why you have to have any, without any disturbance, simply this pulse, ideal pulse, that is 0 thickness and infinite height and area under the curve equal to 1, the same pulse you have to just inject at time t equal to 0. And now, here this is T bar equal to volume by volumetric flow rate, this is volume V. So, at this point, it just comes out, just for representation, this is at T bar, because it is ideal pulse, disk. Okay. Disk you cannot imagine as pulse, because you know thickness should be infinity and all that. So, there is a very, 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 very thin color slide just inside. Okay. Nanometer thick. Nanometer thick disk which just entered, and we know that because it is ideal, without any disturbance, that nice beautiful very thin red color will be moving without any disturbance till here, and that also exactly time t bar equal to volume by volumetric time, it will just come out. If that equal to 10 minutes or 10 seconds, it will exactly come out at 10th second. Now, how do I represent this as an equation, because there is no derivation here for this. right. So, here the Dirac delta function is entering something like this, but this is t equal to 0. How do I write an equation for this? This is delta t minus 0. If I can call this one as E t, this is at 0 time. E t normally we have to only write here. Okay? E t only we have to write there, but that is why I think I will simply mention that the mathematical function is delta t minus 0. What is the meaning of this, Abhijit? This is a pulse input definition, valid only at time t equal to 0. So, now what is the equation here? So, the same output that is here, it comes out at t bar. This we can call now as E t, because that is the exit edge distribution function. Actually, it is a distribution function, but only mathematical definition is thickness equal to 0, correct, no? And height equal to infinity and area under the curve equal to 1. So, that is why here we have E t at the exit delta t minus t bar. So, what you have to remember here is this is valid only at t equal to t bar, and on all other times it is 0, right. So, now I can imagine the same thing with theta, theta equal to t by t bar. So, now how do I write that here? This is theta, delta theta minus 0, right. And here E theta equal to, excellent, theta minus 1, right. So, this is delta theta minus 1, because we know in this case t by t bar equal to 1, right. Yeah, because all the material is coming exactly at, and this is valid, this function is valid only at theta equal to 1. In all other times, what is E theta? 0, right. Yeah. So, that is the one. And of course, E theta now definition is that Dirac delta function where it has got area equal to 1, thickness equal to 0, height equal to infinity. So, that is why this is very easy for us to discuss, no problem at all. So, next one is step input. Step input, right. For step input, how do we represent step input in pictorially? Here I have, normally we put like this, no? This is at t equal to 0, at t equal to 0. And now, what will happen? So, now I switched over from white fluid to red fluid, right. So, then actually, if you have ideal plug flow, doing that experiment will be really beautiful, and if you like colors, okay, white fluid and red fluid, and like piston, the white fluid will be simply displaced till this point, and then finally, here you will have only red fluid, and white fluid you will not have any trace of it, right. Yeah. So, if, when I see at t bar by 2, t equal to t bar by 2, this one 50%, all this side will be red, all this side will be beautiful white, right. So, after some time if you go to 0.75, then this will be red and that will be white. So, that is the imagination for, that is why we call piston flow also. Plug flow, piston flow equation, I mean that name has come because of that. It just simply pushes like a piston. You know, you would have seen how the piston is moving in some machinery. So, there it beautifully goes forward and without, very smoothly, without any sound and all that, particularly old rail engines. Okay? I think new rail engines also have the piston, I think. Yeah, all engines have that. Okay? So, that is the what? Piston flow. And the piston, the ending point must be exactly like flat velocity profile. Then only it is moving like this. Of course, we are only talking one forward direction. So, it moves like a piston. Exactly, that is what is happening here, exactly at 50% of the time, I have a piston, red piston, simply pushing the white piston outside. Okay? So, now, what is the equation we can write here? If I am writing in terms of time, f t, yeah, What is FT? Okay, I will give the clue. FT, if T less than T bar, what is FT?
Zero.
So, this is FT equal to 0 for T, less than T bar. So, now FT equal to 1 for T, for greater than or equal to T bar. Similarly, now F theta. What is F theta, Swami? 0 or less than 1. And the other one is 1 for theta. That's all the equations. It's very simple. Okay, but only thing is understanding direct delta function. Now let us take mixed flow. MF. Okay, so for MF, okay, conducting experiment for MF also is very easy. Okay, so if I take, let me take step input here and write the equation, step input equation, and I will ask you to derive for pulse input. Okay. You have to write the material balance and then not differentiating F you have, F you will have an equation. So, if you differentiate that equation, you will get also E t, not that. You have to write the material balance for tracer and then only derive, it is not that easy. Okay. So, that is why I am telling you, but I am taking these also, both are equally complicated or both are equally simple. So, that is why FT let me take, that is step input. So, this is volumetric flow rate. So, this is here, I have tank here with C naught. So, both are anyway connected here. So, once this is open, that is closed, this is open, this is closed. So, at time t equal to 0, C equal to C naught, it is entering, and immediately after that, you will see some concentration coming out, right? Good. So, now after some time t, it is a step input. That means, continuously tracer is entering, whereas that is the difference between this and the other one. So, when pulse input, only at time t equal to 0, you add 10 grams of tracer. Suddenly here, anywhere you can add, because if it is ideal perfect mixing, everywhere it will mix instantaneously, right? So, then onwards, no more tracer input. But here in step input, step input I have to write. Okay. For step input, we have continuously entering. So, now let us write tracer balance, input equal to output, this is universal equation, plus accumulation plus reaction. Okay. What are the terms I can remove there?
Reaction.
Only reaction, but why not accumulation? As far as flow is concerned, it is steady. But as far as tracer is concerned, it is
unsteady.
Tracer is unsteady state. It will become steady state once all the entire thing is removed, then finally you will have only C0. Okay. So, that is why what you are writing for the balance, for the tracer is non-ideal, unsteady state, that is the reason. Okay. So, now this is 0, what is input in terms of grams per time?
V C0.
Let us say grams per second.
V C0.
This is V into C0 continuously entering, correct, no?
Mm-hmm.
What is coming out after time t equal to 0? So, V into C continuously coming out. And what is accumulation? V into DC by
DT.
We are writing simply C because there is no A and all that, there is no reaction there. We are not talking about reaction of certain compound. Okay, good. So, now this is what we have to solve. So, it is a first order differential equation and it needs at least one boundary condition. What is that logical boundary condition you take?
T is equal to 0, C is equal to C0.
Yeah, T equal to 0, BC. C equal to 0 in the outlet. Outlet only, no? Okay? Yeah. And those people who do not believe this, you try with a T equal to 0 as initial condition, as C equal to C naught. You will not get a solution. That is why mathematics and sometimes physics will not accept. Okay? Yeah. Because mathematics and physics needs a chemistry between them. Okay? So, that is why. Okay, good. So, now I think I will ask you to solve this, right? Or one more step shall I give? You can solve it, no? Excellent, very good. Yeah, what you get here? Oh, someone already solved it. Yeah, C by C naught equal to?
1 minus e power?
Minus t by tau.
Yeah. Minus t by tau, or here we are using
t bar.
That is what. And by definition of C by C naught, what is that? Ft. Because we already proved that for Ft. So, this is also equal to Ft. Good? Yeah. So, now what is F theta? We know that Ft equal to F theta. Yeah. So, this is F theta equal to 1 minus e power minus
theta.
Okay. From this you can calculate what is e theta. What is e theta?
Theta e raised to minus theta.
E theta equal to Rahul?
Minus theta.
E power minus?
Theta. Minus theta by minus theta. That is e raised.
Okay. Yeah, and I feel, you know, this is one of the simplest model equations in chemical engineering. Simplest model equation. It is representing a model. What is that model? Mixed flow reactor. Okay, RTD function. So you see, so beautiful, very simple. Need not be always complicated equation when you say mathematical model, right? This also a mathematical model for CSTR or mixed flow reactor. Good. Yeah. Now. So, if I plot this, you will get this kind of response here, like, you know, this one. Here also I should have plotted for Ft. For Ft, you should have got this is theta equal to 1. So, this is F theta, this is 1. Okay? And this also, of course, T also you will get at T equal to T bar, that also equal to, this is how you have to get the response from the outlet. Similarly, here, how do I plot this response, Ft? Because now I am plotting this equation. Ft. Yeah, okay. Et, what is Et?
Exponentially decreasing.
Et. Accept or no? Don't accept.
Et.
Et will be e power minus T by T bar by T bar. This is what is E t. I think Sushmita looks so tired. Most of you look tired except me. Yeah, but you know, that is not excuse. I have some more, one more thing. Because the moment I saw slight consideration, so immediately I think, you know, yeah, sure, and all. No, no, this is one more last part is there. That also takes quick time, and because I want you to see 12th, I can take the class, and 13th is holiday, unfortunately. For me, unfortunately, because I do not have any other work except this. So, then again, 14th, we do not have class.
14th, we have exam.
So, I have to take only class on 15th then.
So,
that is why I am trying to finish as quickly as possible. Next week itself, okay. Otherwise, maximum Monday, right? So that is the reason why I am just pulling. And I think that today, I think I am on dot. I think whatever I thought, I have to tell, because 12 o'clock. Because other one, I think, you know, once you know all these, then you will have a nice way of finding out. Like doctor, I will give you some curves. You have to tell me the answer. What is the disease with this particular equipment. That is all, it is only diagnostics, right? Okay, that will come later. So, now let us plot this one. F t when I am plotting versus t only. So, it is an exponential curve, 1 minus e power minus t by t bar. So, it will be something like this. Okay. Abdul, when it reaches infinity? When f t reaches 1?
Infinity.
Answer. Answer I already told. This is question paper answer out before, you know, examination. Okay, yeah. So, yeah. So, when t equal to infinity only, then it becomes?
0.
Then you will have f t equal to 1. Right? Okay, good. Now, I will ask you another question. Within 1 t bar, t equal to t bar, what is f t?
63.2%.
Very seriously started calculating. Okay, good. So, this is t bar by t bar. So, this will be, may not be exactly scale, but anyway, 63.632. Okay. So, what is the meaning of that? What is I funda? What is decay? What is initial rate? Totally, I think Trivikram rate is always a high brain, I think. Not easy to understand. Tell me. So? What rate you are talking? I am simple. My question is, I am simple fellow. My question is very simple. What is the meaning of this, that 0.632 at t bar? That 0.63 is f t, not time. What is definition of FTA, sir? What is the definition of FT? Fraction of material which has stayed a time? T. That means, what is the meaning? Straightforward meaning is 63% of the material is spending only one mean residence time. Correct, no? So, the remaining 30%, what is happening? More than that. Okay? Yeah, it is taking the, you know. So, that is the one of the reasons, again, because of the residence time distributions. And whereas, what is this T bar? How much material come in a plug flow reactor? What is FT? FT for a plug flow reactor. Ideal plug flow.
One.
That means, all the molecules are exactly spending same time within, you know, that T bar. And the conversion in each and every particle, I am repeating many times same thing. Okay, so it is each and every particle is exactly converted. So the final conversion, average conversion, also is same for all the packets or particles. Okay, in a plug flow reactor. Whereas here, the 63% is coming in the first one mean residence time. Not only that, initially something is coming, and afterwards sometime some more material is coming. After some time, some more material is coming. Right? So, that means, I can now calculate what is the fraction of material coming between time t plus delta t, or otherwise between 0th minute and first minute. 0th minute and first minute, what is the material that is coming? How do you calculate that? Okay, this is E t versus t. How do you plot this? How do I plot this? Actually, I have to plot, Okay. E t versus t, how do I plot? Where it has to start decreasing?
1 by t1.
That is very important. So at t equal to 0, this is nothing but 1 by
t bar.
And then exponential decay. And Abdul, what time it reaches 0?
Infinite.
Okay. Now I can calculate from here the t bar is somewhere here. Okay. What is the fraction of material between some time t and t plus delta t? Yeah. Okay. This is what is the advantage of plotting this one as e theta. E theta versus theta. Yeah. Now, what is the starting point for e theta versus theta? So, one starts and then goes like this. So, this is theta equal to 1. Okay. Now, can you tell me when between theta equal to 0.2 to 0.3, theta equal to 0.2 to 0.3, what is the fraction coming out? You have equation, I say, e theta.
E raised to minus theta, e power minus theta, e raised to 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 minus theta.
What did I say? Between 0.22 and 0.3. So, the average time is what?
0.25.
Theta equal to 0.25. Delta theta equal to? Your calculator. Your calculator. 2.1. You have to calculate e power minus 2.5 into 0.1, exactly into 0.1. That is the percentage of material that is coming between this time. Okay. So now I don't know whether you are appreciating, you know, why we have to make dimensionless recovery. So I don't have to mention now any timing. Okay. So theta equal to 0.1 to 0.2, that is 0.1 interval. And anyway, the average I have to take, because that means we are only trying to find out something like this. That is why that average, you know, this equal to this. Okay. So this value is around how much you said? 7%. Okay. 7.8%. Almost 8% of the material is pending between 0.2 to 0.3 theta. Okay. So, like that, I think we can calculate at whatever fraction, and correspondingly we can calculate what is the conversion in that and take the average of all that, then you will get the average conversion from that. Okay? Good. So, now, yeah, this is the laminar flow. The next one is laminar flow. Ideal reactor is PF and also MF. I think to divert you, I think I will dictate something for laminar flow. Laminar flow, I think Leon Spiel has done so beautifully. Okay, please take this. When a vessel is long enough, then the dispersion or tanks in series model well describes its flow behavior. Full stop. But how long is long enough? Question mark. This is vague words, you know, always we use long enough. Okay. But how long is long enough? Okay. Question mark ends. Then next. For packed beds and for turbulent flow in pipes, just about any vessel length is long enough. However, for laminar flow in pipes, we may be in other flow regimes, in particular that of the pure convection model. Pure convection model. Convection. Okay. Pure convection model. Okay, full stop. Let us first look at the extremes for laminar flow. Okay, good. One. I think you can put 1, say that if the tube is long enough, we are talking about only laminar flow now, then the molecular diffusion in the lateral direction will have enough time to distort the parabolic velocity profile so that the dispersion model applies. Now, second below, next point, if the tube is short enough, and the flow rate is high, and the flow rate is high, then molecular diffusion has not enough time to act. So, all we need to consider as causing a spread in residence time of fluid is the velocity profile. Full stop. We are in pure convection regime. Third point is, if flow is so slow that the main movement of fluid is by molecular diffusion, not by bulk flow, then we enter the pure diffusion regime. Full stop. We rarely meet this situation in chemical engineering. Good. I think next para you write. Gases are likely to be in dispersion regime. Not in the pure convection regime. Full stop. Liquids can well be in one regime or other. Very viscous liquids such as polymers are likely to be in the pure convection regime. Yeah. Next para. The pure convection model assumes that each element of fluid slides past its neighbor with no interaction by molecular diffusion. Full stop. Thus, the spread in residence times is caused only by velocity variations. This is in fact beautiful information. I am sure none of you would have seen this. Okay? Yeah. I don't know, at this point of time you may not appreciate in the class, but I think you know this is wonderful information. What is entire thing told is that we always assume that we have beautiful parabolic velocity profile. You know, the life of this beautiful parabolic velocity profile is only in seconds. If it is gases, immediately after the formation of that profile, even at low flow rates, molecule starts moving up and down radially, laterally, and also you know axially, all that. So, that means it is no more a parabolic profile. If you do not have parabolic profile, you do not have laminar flow. That is why laminar flow is called pure convection model, because there is no molecular movement. Once that laminar flow starts, like the basic definition everyone tells in fluid mechanics class is, imagine that sliding of pack, you know, pack of cards. That is what we say. That is also told here. So, that means without any disturbance with the pack below or the card below, it is simply sliding without any disturbance. That will happen only for high viscous fluids, just for some time. So, when you have that kind of clear definition for laminar, which is called also pure convection model, the residence time distribution is only because of profile. Otherwise, if there is a molecular movement, so that also will disturb this profile and your residence time distribution will be disturbed. That is why this is a very restricted case, which is called pure convection model. This I think you would have not heard. Anyone heard of this? I do not think anyone of you heard of this. That pure convection model is only possible with parabolic velocity profile, and when we are talking this one, as you know, in polymer this comes as a reactor. In polymer processing, laminar flow reactors can be used. So, that is why we need to know what kind of residence time distributions we get, and those residence times are purely by velocity variations if you have parabolic velocity profile like this. Right? That is why for gases it is not possible, and for liquids with less viscosity and all that also, that will be very, very disturbed very, very quickly. Right? And what happens is, if you allow that for some more time, if you have sufficient length, you can use normal dispersion mode, because by the time molecules arrange it themselves, it is flow, it is convection. No? Yeah, it is not pure convection. By convective flow, material is moving and molecules are getting dispersed here up and, because molecules are moving up and down laterally, radially and all that. So, you will get this kind of distribution, this kind of normal distribution. Right? So, how do we now develop an equation, RTD equation ET for this one, ET and FT? Okay? If you are not able to say, now, okay, Shoshu, what can we do with? Can we change the 5 minutes? They will also relax. Okay, yeah. Because let me complete this, I think, you know, again, before that, I think we can also draw another figure, which will nicely represent the same thing. You can draw this figure. that is actually the meaning of laminar flow. It is like one pipe inside, over that another pipe, over that another pipe, and all of them are moving like that without disturbing the other pipes. That is what we say, this pack of cards. Okay. And I think this is very important information. None of you definitely would have known this kind of information till now. And the center is somewhere here. So that is what is this profile meaning, parabolic profile. Okay. So the material which is there on the top tip of this will go much faster. Okay. Yeah. So now, when we want to derive an equation for this, we need some information about fluid mechanics. So this total length is L. Okay, Shoshu, can I continue? Okay, yeah, changed already. Okay, so this is L, and of course this is R equal to 0. This is total. Okay. This is capital R. Yeah, so we have an equation, all of us know about this, is that we have u r equal to u m maximum velocity, yeah, 1 minus r by r whole square. This is equation 1. Let me put the equations for this. So we also know u bar equal to average velocity equal to u m by 2. That is equation 2. Okay, these things from fluid mechanics. And we also know that t time is nothing but length by u r. Correct? No. Velocity time, length by velocity. And this is also equal to L by u r, is this u m 1 minus r by r whole square. Correct? Yeah, this is equation number 3. Yeah. Now, substituting this equation here, equation 2 in 3, equation 2 in 3, what you get is t equal to t bar 2 1 minus r by r whole square. Yeah, of course, where t bar equal to mean residence time, t bar equal to mean residence time. Yeah, how t bar is defined? This is equation 4. Yeah, so t bar equal to L by u bar, that is the equation. So now, this important thing what we have to understand, afterwards it is only mathematics. The fraction of material between r and r plus delta r, r plus delta r corresponding to times t and t plus delta t is e t delta t given by volume flow of fluid between r and r plus delta r, divided by total volume of fluid. Okay, let me explain this. The definition of ET delta T, we know that is the fraction of material spending a time between T and T plus delta T. Now, this pipe will, this diagram will give you a nice picture there. Because when I have some r here, you know, from center, okay, this is r, and maybe slightly delta r is somewhere here. Okay, so between, okay, you can also imagine this r and delta r is a small pipe with a thickness of delta r, right. So, depending on its position here, so that is coming, you know, if you take this one as the delta r, that is coming the fastest, right. So, this also corresponding to some time, that means when this is coming earlier, so that is also corresponding to some time earlier, some time t. That means each concentric pipe which is coming at different r's will come here at different times. This one will come in the shortest time. What is that t bar by 2? Somewhere middle if I take, that will take some other time. And somewhere only small delta r if I take near the wall, that takes lot of time. Right. So, that is what is the simple definition here. That means there is a relationship between r and t and r plus delta r and t plus delta t. So, in this flow, when I am imagining that these are all the concentric tubes, this tube and minus this tube, so that is the fluid, this is one tube and around that we have another pipe, okay, imaginary pipe, and that volume of that one will come in a different time, corresponding to its own velocity. Why? Velocity is changing along the radius, correct, no? Different velocities at different radial positions. That is why they spend different times. So, that is what is this, and that means if I take one annulus, that is the volume of fluid between r and r plus delta r, which is automatically connected with some t and delta t. How do you get that t and r connection? We will deal later. This is the basic definition. Okay? So, now, if I write an equation, I mean the equation for this E t delta t will be, what is volume flow of fluid between r and delta plus r? If you remember your fluid mechanics earlier, it will be u r 2 pi r into d r, okay, or delta r, right? I can also write delta r. So, divided by what is the total? Total flow rate. Total flow rate is simply u bar pi r square, correct? No? That is the volumetric flow rate, cross sectional area multiplied by the u bar. This is u bar, right? Okay. So, this is equation number 5. Okay, of course, pi pi can get cancelled. Good. So, now another thing that is left to understand is, yeah, this equation 4 is now actually we have already the relation. The equation 4 relates r and corresponding time, correct, no? Yeah, r and corresponding time. So, now you can differentiate this, differentiate equation 4, differentiate equation 4 with respect to t. So, to get dt, okay, I think, you know, with respect to t, I do not have to write, okay. Yeah. Okay, dr by dt or dt by dr also we can write. So, differentiate equation 4 like this, dt equal to, can someone differentiate quickly? Dt by dr. Dr you can bring that side. At least one person, if he differentiates and tells me, raise me quickly. Sorry, for Wali.
T by 1 minus r by r square.
T bar by 2.
R square.
T bar 1 minus
r. Okay. T bar.
R by r into r.
T bar r by r.
T by 1 minus r square whole square.
Excellent. That is correct thing. So, I mean, many people would have not tried, I know, because you are tired. So, what you get for dt is t bar, no, I am just writing this one, t bar by 2, so that, you know, later for me it is a little bit easier. Actually, what he said is right, and also I am writing t bar 2 r by r square, correct, no? What he said is this 2 will get cancelled, okay, that is what you said. and then dr divided by 1 minus r by r square and whole square. That is the one, that is dt. Okay. Yeah. And from equation 4, this equation, what is t by t bar? From equation 4, t by t bar equal to, not t, okay. Two t bar by 2 equal to 1 minus r by r whole square, correct? Huh? The right side. 2 t by 2 equal to, this is 1, this is equation.
T bar by
2 t. T bar, yeah, yeah. T bar by 2. Yeah, right, you are right. Equal to this one, 1 minus r by r square. So, this is equation 7. Okay. So, using now equations 7 and also 6, yeah, and substitute here in this equation, oh yeah, 6, this is 6, this is 6, yeah, okay, et delta t you have to use, yeah, I am just thinking about your timing, you know, whether you are able to take, otherwise I have, okay, I think let me do, and so once we start doing that, okay. Okay, please take write this, substituting equation 7 in 6 and rearranging, substituting equation 7 in 6 and rearranging, what you get is r dr or delta r, okay, I think let me write dr only, delta r dr same here. So, I think here also I will write dr only, r dr equal to capital R square t bar by 4 into dt by t square. So, can someone check, this is equation number 8, correct? So, now another thing is, now substitute equation 8 in 5, in this equation, substituting equation 8 in 5, equation 8 in 5, what you get is E t d t equal to u by u bar t bar by 2. So, this is equation number 9. Okay. Okay. So, we also have equation from 1 and 2. From equation 1 and 2, what you have is u r by u bar equal to 2 into 1 minus r by r whole square. So, this is equation 10. U by u bar equal to, yeah, okay, good. So, now 7 and 10 can I combine, what do I get? U r by u bar equal to t bar by t. So, from equations 10 and 7, what you get is u r by u bar equal to t bar by s. So, this is only just for converting one from the other. Okay. So, now substitute 11 in, this is equation 11. Can you tell me, substituting 11 in 9? Yeah. So, Ramakrishna, what did you get? E t d t equal to? T bar square?
By 2 square.
D t by?
2 t cube. D t by t square.
2 t cube. So, this is equation 12. Now, what is E t?
T bar square by
2
t cube.
T cube. So, this is the equation for laminar flow, E t, exit distribution function. And yeah, so this is equation 13, but I think before writing 13 there, is there any limitation for this? When it is valid, when it is not valid? When is this valid? If I answer that, I think that okay, you are still alive. Huh? It is valid only between 0 to t bar by 2. Yeah. No, you start seeing the fluid only after t bar by 2. Because you know from fluid mechanics, the average velocity is twice of the maximum velocity, right? Correct?
Half
of the maximum velocity. Yeah, okay. U bar equal to half the maximum velocity. So that is why t bar by 2 is the first time what you see the tracer coming out. Okay? So that is why the limitation here is this is valid only for t greater than or equal to t bar by 2. And et will be 0 for t less than t bar by 2. Okay. Now tell me e theta. E theta is again one of the very beautiful equations. E theta equal to, oh, this is 14, 1 by, excellent, 1 by 2 theta cube. This is another equation which I like. The first equation is E theta equal to e power minus theta for mixed flow reactor. Okay? So, this will be good. So, this will be again validity theta greater than or equal to half 1 by 2. So, this is equation 15 and E theta equal to 0 for theta less than 1. Okay? So, we can also just we can integrate this and then try to put the limits, because f theta equal to integral 0 to theta e theta d theta. So, this will be 1 minus 1 by 4 theta square. This will be f theta, which is also equal to f t. So, this equation is 16, that is equal to 16. Okay? So, this derivation is not, you know, maybe at this point of time you are not able to observe, but the derivation is not at all difficult. Okay? But only algebra comes after definition of writing volume of the fluid between r plus delta r by total volume, that is all. Afterwards, it is only mathematical manipulation where you can easily find out. But only I just want to ask you, how do you draw this e theta versus t or e theta versus theta? Yeah. You are very good, yeah. It is not 0, okay? Yeah, it is valid only from half theta, half to theta, okay? Upper limit. Then only you get that, otherwise you do not get that, okay? Good. So, how do I plot this? E theta versus theta. Where does it start?
Theta equals
theta direction is part the
half.
Oh, yeah. So till what point I have to go?
Cubically.
What is this starting point? Excellent. I think still some people are alive. Okay, this is 4. Yeah, then afterwards, how does that go?
The half hour,
huh?
2 cube, that is 8 by 2, 4.
Decreases as 1 by x cube.
1 by x cube.
Yeah. 1 by x square, 1 by x cube, 1 by x we have, no? 1 by x cube, no? 1 by theta cube. So, this falls very fast, it goes like this. This is not exponential. Why I am drawing now is that this is not exponential, like that is also decreasing, but that
cubic.
Yeah, mixture flow is decreasing exponentially down, e power simply minus theta. But this is 1 by 2 theta cubed. Okay? So, that is why it comes out here. So, somewhere here you will have theta equal to 1. What is the value of e theta at theta equal to 1? yeah, somewhere here, 0.5, okay. So now you see on the same thing, if I just show you like okay, for plug flow, on the same graph I just want to plot plug flow, right, E theta, how do I plot? What, Swami? Still this fellow is not leaving, huh? Yeah, so F theta, sorry, I mean, yeah, E theta for plug flow. Theta equal to 1, this is for PF, okay. At theta equal to 1, and for mixed flow, yeah, at theta equal to 1 somewhere here, it goes exponential decay. So this is MFR, that is PFR, okay, and this is see, all three ideal equations, I mean ideal things are there, okay, yeah. But only one thing is left, I think, what I thought today doing, you know, now the diagnostics, maybe I think we will do in the next class, because I think maybe it is too much for you. This also, I don't know how many people have absorbed that, but God knows, it may be in third quiz.